Thousands of troops deployed to the U.S.-Mexico border by President Trump have spent weeks laying concrete and raising razor wire. What if they were making music, not walls? Our next guest is not mad. He doesn't actually think that Donald Trump or his troops are likely to take up partying on the border anytime soon. But people can, and that might actually connect people whom concrete and bad law have driven apart. Inspired by musician and retired librarian, Fandango Fronterizo is a sort of border crossing festival that is now in its 11th year. Not long ago, acclaimed jazz pianist Arturo O'Farrell attended with top-line musicians from all over the world, and the result is Fandango at the Wall, a soundtrack for the United States, Mexico, and beyond. Over 30 tracks recorded in Tijuana and New York, he wants the album to inspire people to adopt what he calls the Fandango Doctrine, wherever they are. We're about to find out how to do that. First, a part of the video for Fandango at the Wall, Arturo O'Farrell's collaboration is produced by Grammy Award winner Kabir Segal and available via Resilience Music Alliance. Arturo O'Farrell is joining me in studio. I should say he is also founder and artistic director of the nonprofit Afro-Latin Jazz Alliance, as well as the Afro-Latin Jazz Orchestra. Arturo, welcome to the show, and thank you. That's just gorgeous.
It's beautiful. I was looking at the scenes and just remembering. It's kind of hard to believe that we did that. It's just, it mobilized an army of what seemed like thousands.
Now, you had people from all over the world. If people couldn't see the small print, who were some of the musicians you had there?
We had incredible musicians. We had Rahim Al-Haj, Iraqi-born Udis, Saba Motalebi from Iran, Antonio Sanchez, the composer of Birdman for the film, MacArthur Fellow Regina Carter, the entire Afro-Latin Jazz Orchestra, and of course, the incredible Jorge Francisco Castillo, who's the founder of the Fandango Fronterizo, and the wonderful musicians that he brought, including Ramon Gutierrez Herrera and Patricio Hidalgo, who are practitioners of the deepest art.
So I wasn't aware, forgive me, of the Fandango Fronterizo. I had no idea. In now 11 years, Give me some of the backstory. And am I just been missed out of the loop for 11 years?
It's something that's not front page news. It was in the New York Times, and that's how I learned about it. But what literally happens is that musicians, son jarocho musicians, which is a style of music from Veracruz, which is also known as Afro-Mexican music, and it was invented in Veracruz. A group of musicians from the Mexican side gathered with a group of musicians, practitioners of this art, at the border and actually play across the mesh. Mm-hmm. And what's very touching is that sometimes these are folks that are family and they're separated by the political border, mm-hmm. and they cannot physically see each other, but they come and they celebrate unity. Mm-hmm. And they celebrate unity at the very symbol that keeps them apart. And I find that so compelling and so beautiful and so magical and mystical. It destroys the idea that music and community and Pueblo destroy physical barriers is something that affected me deeply. And so when I read about it, I contacted Jorge Kabir, my friend, and executive producer, contacted Jorge. We went there and we said, we need to just be a part of this. And that's what we did. We didn't go to impose ourselves. We went to bring all these musicians to actually jam with them. And then we, you know, recorded other stuff. But
now you weren't there when the troops were there. I mean, more than your average number of troops. You recorded this before Donald Trump's most recent deployment. But was there anything about the border that surprised you, that was new? What was it like for you to be down there on the negative side, if you will, before you get to the...
That's funny. I find border patrol people a lot like police officers. Some of them are good, some of them are bad, some of them are racist, some of them are not. But they're all caught up in a terrible cycle of hatred and violence. The tension in this nation has gone absolutely beyond the norm. And there's so much tension between people in authority and the rest of us that it's palpable. And I think that there's probably a good number of border patrol officers and army that is stationed now at the border that wishes this whole thing would just go away. The truth of the caravan and the migrants that are coming is overblown. It's just crazy, and this clearly political agenda that the president is playing is almost a last grab, a desperate measure for attention, because he knows that this is the dying moment of that style of politicking.
So how did all those folks respond to you coming down with your musician friends? How do they respond to the Fandango every year?
You know, it's funny, because I think that they have a rough job. We didn't really get to interact with the Customs Borders Patrol. But I know that the people that attended this thing, it's a little bit like, I don't know if it's a combination between Burning Man and Woodstock. There was just this feeling of magic in the air again. People come from all over the world to learn Son Jarocho music, to participate in this festival. And the thing that touched me is that I have been a big band jazz musician for many years, and I know how difficult it is to make a living. And some of our musicians are very nonplussed, let's put it that way. And they were in tears.
Yeah.
And whenever you see the journeyman in tears, that's a powerful moment. Because we harden ourselves in our day-to-day lives to do what we're able to do. And to break through that barrier and to really touch hearts is something that I find amazing. And
so now there's something known as the Fandango Doctrine, and you're a prophet of it.
I believe so. I think the Fandango Doctrine is that culture, community, conscience is more important than governance, is more important than xenophobia. It's even more important than profiteering by division.
Shock horror.
Yeah, right. I know, hard to believe.
Even in America?
I think it's a worldwide trend. But it's interesting to me to see that people are really responding. And you can see that in the midterm elections. People are responding to some desperate need for a change in our attitude.
So if people want to do a Fandango where they live, as you're encouraging, what do they do?
Well, they go to, and it's really funny because the mesh at the border wall is just, there's just enough space to touch fingertips. So we were high pinking. So I'm going to try and make that an international symbol of Fandango Doctrine, the high pinky.
The high pinky.
Yeah, the high pinky.
All right.
Just do the high pinky. And, I wonder if that means anything else. I don't know.
Well, sure.
But anyway, the idea is to touch pinkies with someone who you love and just let them know that it's more important to be human than to be a commodity. It's more important to be human than to be a cog. It's more important to be a human than to be part of a doctrine that is anti-human.
Thank you. All right.
Hi,
pinky.
Hi, pinky.
Okay, Arturo Farrell, everybody.
Thank you,
Laura. Find more about the album and how you can do your own Fandango at our website.